Okay, so the other day when getting to my cottage, there was an insane sunset right by where we were passing by. So I asked my sister to stop the car. I ran outside with my Google Pixel 4 to capture some pictures. And when I got back, I wanted to share them on my Instagram stories. Before doing that, I wanted to quickly edit them. So I opened up Google Photos and realized there's some pretty neat new editing features inside of the app. So this allowed me to edit this picture to look like this one to look like this, and this one to look like this. Let's see how I did these edits, and let's start by rolling the intro. For those of you who are new to this channel, I'm Luc Ben-Mahalford, a young photographer and filmmaker on a journey to become better at this art. It's been a little while I didn't do editing tutorial, so I'm pretty excited about doing this video. Let's jump right into the first picture. Okay, so now let's move right into the first picture right here. And if we look at this one, it looks pretty good, but there's not enough colors inside of the sky like I would want it. And that's because I focused on the mountains here to make sure that we could see them and have them visible. But that means they reduced the amount of contrast on the whole picture, which doesn't make the colors pop as much. But now there's a very easy way of fixing this. So if we come here and we go on edit, we're gonna see that we have new enhance modes here, so we can click on enhance. It's gonna help a little bit, but if we scroll further away, we're gonna see here we have new modes like vivid, luminous, radiant, amber, airy, afterglow, and stormy. But if we come here, I think the one that looks the best here is radiant. So if one quick, we already have a much better looking picture. So if we look at before, we look at after, we're gonna see that it's actually night and day in terms of editing. These new features are free for all Google Pixel users, but they might require a Google One subscription for other people. I'm not exactly sure how it works, but I'm gonna put the link down in the description about the terms of this. But now if you wanted to edit it a little bit more and have a little bit more of our look, not just a one-click edit, we can actually remove the effect here. I'm not gonna crop it or straighten it, but like that, I would normally do that at the beginning. But then if we come here on the adjust tab, we have our normal options here. So we have brightness, contrast, but the new one is here, is sky. And I was a little bit scared when I heard they were gonna add options to edit the sky because I'm not a big fan of sky replacements, but here they're actually not replacing the sky. They're only enhancing the colors. And what is the normal edit I would do instead of Lightroom, something like that. But this is a one click edit. So if we come here, we can have vivid, we can have luminous, radiant, amber. So it's really between amber and radiant for me, but I think radiant really works well here. Then we have a slider here so we can make the effect less visible, more visible. So I think if we go at the max, it's too much. So something maybe around like 60% is actually looking pretty good. So if we look at before, after, it already looks much better. So if we click done here, the next thing I'm gonna do is just add a little bit more contrast so that the mountains become a little bit darker because I wanna really have more contrast on the sky and things like that. Now, if you come on the next options here, we're actually gonna go on a white point and just bring our whites up a little bit, bring our highlights down a little bit more to add more color inside of the sky right here. Then we're just gonna go on black point and bring it down a little bit more just to add even more black inside of the mountains. We're not gonna touch the saturation, warmth, tint, skin tones, or anything else, but we're gonna come at the end here and look at two new other options. So we now have a denoise option, which is a much needed feature that was missing inside of Google Photos. So if we zoom inside of this image, we might see that there's a little bit noise inside of the trees here. We actually don't see it too much, but if we just add a little bit noise reduction, it's gonna help. But then we can also have a new option, which is sharpen. So we can even sharpen a little bit more the image right here. So now if we zoom back out and we look at this image, we have before, we have after, and this is how easy it was to edit this image with the new editing options. So now we're gonna save the copy and we're gonna look at another image. So this is the second image I have right here that I took last night. It looks pretty good, but I don't really like the look that it has, which is way too much blue. So again, if we go inside of the edit options, we're gonna see that it's super easy to fix. So if we come here and we go on amber, or radiant. Radiant doesn't look that good, but I think if we go on amber here, we're gonna see it looks much better. So again, one click and the image is pretty much fixed. But I wanna customize it a little bit more, so I'm gonna remove the amber option here, then go and adjust, go again on our sky tab, find amber, bring this up, maybe bring it a little bit more. In this case, I actually want it to be a bit more intense. Then we're gonna click done, go in our other options, again, bring down a little bit the highlights, but bring up the white points. No, maybe bring down the white points. I'm also just gonna go on the shadows here and bring down the shadows a little bit more to make the sky pop a little bit more, and bring down the blacks really to add a bit more contrast. Again, I'm not gonna touch saturation, warmth, or thing like that. Warmth, we could play with it a little bit here if we wanted to bring it even warmer, but I think that it looked pretty good at zero. Again, we're gonna come here in the last tab and just add a little bit of noise reduction, because if we look at the trees here, we can actually see that there's a little bit of noise inside of the trees. So we're just gonna bring up a bit of noise reduction, apply some sharpening just to bring it back nice and sharp, zoom out, and look at our before, after. You're gonna see it's a huge difference in an edit that took, what, 20 seconds to do, which is pretty incredible that we have these capabilities built in inside of Google Photos on the Google Pixel phones. So the last picture we're gonna look at is actually a very different one that we have here. So this is one that I took a few days ago when I was in Montreal of my school, but here we have a pretty dramatic sky. So the first thing we're gonna come here is actually just straighten it up a little bit more, because it annoys me that it was so crooked. So we're just gonna bring it up like that. Then if we go on our suggestion again, I think we'll go at the end here and click on stormy, but here it's a little bit too blue to my taste. So I'm gonna remove stormy, then go on adjust, go on our sky option again, go on stormy, and actually bring it up a little bit more again on this one, click done. Then we're gonna go on contrast here, and we're gonna bring up the contrast even more just to add even more drama inside of this scene. I might bring up the shadows a little bit just because it's a little bit too dark to my taste. And now the last thing I wanna do is just go inside of warmth, because I think it's a little bit too blue, like it doesn't look natural in the end. So I'm just gonna bring back some warmth inside of this picture. And we're pretty much done with this edit. So again, this is before, this is after, this is before, this is after. So this new sky option is really cool because it allows you to quickly apply effects on the sky and to use AI to detect what is a sky, what are the reflections and everything on the picture. And it's really simple to edit pictures and get much better pictures with just a few clicks in a few seconds. If you enjoyed this little editing tutorial, please let me know by hitting the like button below, and also consider subscribing to the channel for more content on photography and filmmaking. See you in the next one. Bye bye.